Hello guys, welcome back. I'm Julian. I'm here to do my reaction video for season 3, episode 3 of Stupid Wife. This time, the title of the episode is Redenção, which I guess it means redemption or something like that. I'm going from redemption. So yeah, we're here, we're back, we're ready for episode 3. And then episode 4, and we will be all caught up. So that is exciting. I am as excited to watch this episode as I'm excited to watch the next one, because I have watched the thumbnails for both episodes, and they are kind of like, I don't know if they're gonna go there, or because we have like scenes like that, but I don't know. And these two are just like their chemistry. You know, the Priscillas are just, I still, till to this day, I'm not going to be able to understand how actresses, you know, can play significant others and not fall in love with each other. Some do, but like, the straight ones, where they play gays, don't they question it a bit? Or they're like, method actors? I don't know, because I'll be in love, honestly. Anyway, so we're gonna watch episode 3 of season 3, and I'm excited, like I said, and I hope you guys are as excited as I am to watch a new episode of A Stupid Wife. So thank you for watching, thank you for all your support. I hope you guys enjoy, hope you guys like it, hope you guys continue supporting for more. Thumbs up if you love the show, heart if you are on Patreon right now, subscribe, comment, hit the notification bell. Like I said, the uncut reaction is on Patreon, posted first, because this is posted on December 26, 2023. I don't know when it's going to be posted on YouTube. I think as soon as I'm able to edit it. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy whenever you watch it. And just know that if you want to watch the next episode, you can do that by going to Patreon right now. My reaction is already posted. So yeah, hope you guys enjoy, hope you guys like it, and without further ado, let's just begin with season 3, episode 3 of A Stupid Wife. Here we go. Oh, hello, demon. Honestly, the fact that he's not talking to her is like a lot. And you kind of get it where his children are kind, where they get that kindness and patience, because this man, look, I will be like, this can't work. Like, you are making everyone's life miserable. How can I be with someone like that? Let me just say, I'm rooting for the divorce.
Eu desisti da ação da guarda compartilhada.
Oh, okay, good. Although I wanted to see my girl defend her family in court, but still, good for you. You.
Só que os tempos são outros.
Yeah.
E ainda bem que são outros. Eu sempre me senti cobrada. Eu sempre me senti assim.
But girl, like my mom used to make the most embarrassing comments about me when I was younger, and fully knowing how that made me feel, I am the most patient, or I try to have the most patient with my son, you know, now especially that he is a teenager, and we all know how teenagers are, and like, he calls me bro, and I'm like, dude, like, but I get it, you know, because like, at that moment, and like, when he's like, no, like, nobody cares about me, like, I'm like, dude, I mean, I love you, whatever you say, I don't care, I still love you, even when I'm like, screaming that he did something that he shouldn't have, you know, and I raise my voice a bit, and I'm like, I don't care that I'm screaming, but like, I still love you. You're still grounded, by the way, but like, I still love you. Because for me, it's important, because my mom used to play with that, whether if I wanted her love, I had to prove that I was good or something like that, you know? And that's how I felt. And I don't want my kid to feel that way. So I don't do it.
Castigada, sabe? Eu não quero perder minha filha.
Then what the fuck were you thinking?
Eu não quero, não vou.
You have a ghost in your house. Did you saw the ghost? Did you saw the ghost?
Perder a Valentina.
I'm pretty sure that is a crew person, but like, it's a ghost. Lesbian Jesus just walked in.
Eu não quero perder a Valentina.
To shine some light on this bitch.
Valentina.
Hoje é dia de comemoração, então eu tô decretando feriado, Campos Albu. Só hoje, nada de escola e nada de trabalho.
Estamos de férias!
Vamos!
It's so cute, look at them! They're the perfect family. They're the perfect family. I love them so much. I love them so much. Aww.
A gente já vai ficar morrendo de saudade.
Aww. Supporting family.
Bora. Oh. O que, quer me filmar falando isso? Porque é difícil pra mim admitir. Eu nunca mais vou repetir falar. Não, 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 nunca mais. Ai, Valentina, seu sobrinho tá aqui pedindo. O Tico vai pirar, vou mandar pra ele.
What are they exactly doing? The jacuzzi we have seen. Oh!
Mas eu vou estar juntinho aqui com você.
That's why I miss her even more.
Gente, esse romance de colegial de vocês.
Ah, o modelo mais novo, modelo da família.
Yes!
A fotógrafa mais.
It's so adorable, the little kids. You know what, bitch? I know I'm supposed to feel sorry for her, but, like, I'm sorry, but I don't. Do we make mistakes? Yes. But she has made this mistake several times. So it's not a mistake, it's a pattern. That's who she is. And, like, yes, we have this thing, family's family, and, like, but you shouldn't be, you know, forgiving everything all the time. You know? I don't know how I feel about this. Valentina will have to decide, and I will support her. Like the loving wife I am. Your mom is... Wait.
Yes.
I don't want to intrude. Your mom is alive and uses WhatsApp? Because my mom just learned, like, a year ago. My mom's around her age. So, I'm just saying.
Espero que bem. O amor da minha filha.
That's your fault. That's entirely your fault. I'm sorry.
Isso hoje eu entendo. Repetuar eu não vou permitir.
Well, good for you for understand. That's true. Generational trauma. Once you identify it, you caught it. Took you a long time.
Eu tenho que...
True. Okay. Yes. She does have to change.
Obrigada, mãe.
For absolutely nothing, apparently.
Obrigada pra reconquistar o que eu perdi.
That's redemption.
Obrigada,
but it is true. You do have to forgive yourself, forgive the person that brought that trauma and like kind of like let go of that so you can. So I think she's taking the right steps towards truly changing because she does feel like she needs to change. This is not something that is being told to her. It's not something that she has come to that conclusion. And especially to recognize and to forgive her mom and forgive, well, herself a bit, I guess. That will not happen until Valentina forgives her as well. But, you know, that's basically how you... That actually looks like a woman that truly has learned her lesson. Hopefully it sticks, you know. And the whole thing about, like, oh, but we are from another generation and blah, blah, blah. Yeah, but now we have therapy. Now we have resources. And, like, You're not, you can make the same mistakes. And sometimes it's so difficult. I do have to give it to her because it's so difficult to break that cycle that is so engraved in you because of how you were raised. But like for her to take her, what, 28 years? I don't know how old Valentina is. Like, seriously. She's a slow learner.
Frio, calça, uma pra você.
Oh, damn.
Vai dar mal.
Vamos lá.
Se temos mal, né?
A gente se deu mal.
He's so adorable. They are so adorable. When are you gonna deliver that baby, Duda? How long has she been pregnant? 2 seasons now.
Tô com saudade.
I'm gonna have phone sex.
O sorrisinho é esse, Valente.
Bom trabalho, boa sorte.
Beijo.
Aww.
Dá um beijo no Léo por mim.
So, no phone sex. Okay, great. I was not expecting that. I was.
Não tô comendo, amor.
Quero mostrar esse carinho aqui, ó.
That's so cute.
Menina, seja muito amado, muito esperado por nós.
She was pregnant.
Você amou sua barriga?
Yeah.
Especial. A minha.
You're so adorable! Stop it! Oh my god!
Sentiu?
That's so cute.
Voz.
Yeah. Look at that face of love. Oh my god. Find you someone that looks at you like Luisa looks at Valentina and vice versa. How adorable was that?
Cinco.
Professora substituta.
Ah! Your wife! That's so cute. They're gonna dance again. Stop! Okay. Oh, someone is cold. Stop it! You can't. I'm not looking. Guys, stop it. Stop it. Stop it because I'm trying not to look, but they're pointing at me. Wait, hold on. We gotta go back to the. Okay. Okay! Oh, they're doing this in front of people! Why wasn't I invited? I will have gone there just to be a witness of this. I thought they were alone and they're... My god, this horny lesbian side. Love them. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna calm down. I'm gonna calm down. Someone else turn on. Because God knows I am. Oh. Look at the girl! Look at the girl! Look at the girl in the back. Look at the girl in the back. I'm the girl. Tag yourself! I'm the girl in the back that is like. Look at her! Look at her! She's like. That was hot. They haven't had sex in 2 weeks, guys.
Assim você me provoca, Valentina.
Ooh, Valentina.
Eu amo te provocar.
Yeah, I know that. Fucking the table. just a suggestion, you know. Okay. Woo! The romantic music! The sexy music!
Tava morrendo de saudade de você.
Me too!
Eu também.
Oh, they're not gonna fuck there. Oh, they are gonna fuck there! Go for you, girls! Is this her office? Where is this? I don't care. I'm seeing her side boot. Oh my god. Her boob! I think it's her. Ah! Can the camera stop moving? She likes it rough sometimes. Lars, save me! Oh my god. Oh my god, these two are going to. One of these days. One of these days, I'm going to die. Can you guys take off your clothes? I mean, I'm sorry. Oh no, it's cutting out. Okay, no, it's not. Oh! That shit that they have put in front of the camera just for me not to see where Luis is going. Oh my god. Go back. Oh! Oh! Ave Maria Purisima, I feel like I need to be baptized again. So my sins get out of my body. I don't know. I just like... Oh! Oh my god. Oh my god. Should I watch it again? Just for research purposes, you know? Just for research purpose. Okay. The hand in the ass, man. Oh! My god. I love the thing just messes with her hair. That she can't actually take it out. She's like... See? She can't take it out. I love that. That's her boob! I can count her fucking ribs. How is this possible, man? Mama! Goddess! Oh my god.
Quanta saudade.
That was a beautiful scene. Every scene, like, we have seen her, them fuck. Like, you know what level? Because, like, there's another couple that I love, and I never get tired of their love scenes. It's Tibet from The L Word, right? I never get tired. I have seen them fuck in every single position of the Kama Sutra, okay? Because, like, The L Word ran for a long time. Whatever, I'm not going to spoil anything. And then The L Word, Generation Q. That's the level this two compare. Because, like, the chemistry. The just that closeness they have with each other. That trust between the act. I don't know how they're not gay and married to each other, though. Like, to me, that's a mystery. Straight my ass. I don't know. Honestly, can you be that straight? Because God knows I have tried. And like, but you have to be very straight to be in this position and not fall in love with your co-star. And just be besties, you know, because they're besties. But like, honest to God, I don't know how they do it. Reason number 10,000 why I will never be an actor. I will fall in love. I'm not gonna... I should not have done that, but okay. The Lord wanted it. Brazilians. They are born with a... They're born with a soccer ball. Like, that's the deal. They are born and they hang you the baby and the soccer ball. Swear to God. True story, because Brazilians are the best at playing soccer. And I'm glad they're not playing like basketball or anything. Oh, Luisa. That's so adorable. So the two of you are the goalkeepers. I love this. Well, lesbian goalkeepers. Let's go. Oh. That's so adorable. That little boy is like, I gotta get the soccer ball, you know? I can't see her boob. God damn. Yes, goal. That's adorable. They're adorable. Leo's like, get up. Can you guys fuck here again?
I can.
She's doing something. What is she doing?
Nossa, tá tarde, né? Vamos subir?
I think it's a surprise for you. What? Yeah, you're gonna make me think she cheated. Yeah, sure. You horny lesbians, I love this. Look. These peaks are when people most watch the videos. most replayed. Look. This moment. Look at the peak. Look at the peak. You horny lesbians. But like, yes, true. Because after this, I'm going to rewatch that part. Okay, guys, so that was the end of season 3, episode 3 of Stupid Wife. Was that a scene hot? Yes, it was. Does it deserve an Oscar? Yes, it does. Whatever award, just like, there should be an award for like best chemistry. They will win. They will win. Like, I just, what can I say about Luisa and Valentina that I haven't already said? That they're hot? Yes. But that's not what it makes them, you know, powerful and amazing and gorgeous and, you know. Nah, it's their chemistry, man. The chemistry, the actress's chemistry, you know. It's just mind-blowing. Mind-blowing. Okay, because like, do they choreograph everything? Like, do they know where to touch and where not? Or they're like game, or like, I don't know. Because I know that actors do sometimes, you know, for specific scenes, you know, like this, they do have intimacy coordinator or something like that, right? But, like, I feel like they are so them as their characters. I honestly don't think you can, like, actually, like, I don't know. I don't think you can actually, how you say it, give us that level of, like, greatness if it was choreographed or something. I don't know. Like, who the hell am I to know anything about anything? I'm just a bisexual woman just here in love with this show. But yeah, you know, their connection. Because it goes beyond just the sex. I mean, the sex scenes are like fire, right? But how you get there is because of their chemistry. There's no other answer, you know. So thank you to both Priscillas for being this extraordinary, and thank you. You're doing a great service to the entire community, especially to the Latin American community, because like, we have Juliantino, who were, you know, on a Mexican telenovela, and like, their story was epic. I don't think they have repeated, like, do they have another telenovela with a queer lesbian couple? I don't think so, because if there was, you guys will have let me know. But that did wonders, you know, for the community to be able to see, and especially to be able to also see the homophobia within the countries that telenovela, you know, was sold after, because that telenovela was broadcast here in like prime time, but they cut out a lot of Juliana and Valentina's story, especially the kisses, and like, you know, they didn't show that because the homophobic, and that did not only happen in my country, but it also happened in several other countries, and just gets to show you how little, you know, we as a community, the Latino community, the in Latin America, how that is not, you know, supposed to be in prime time, and like, you know, it's more of like, okay, you gay, but like, you be gay, but not in front of us, you know. So it's about tolerance and all of that. But with Stupid Wife, since they are in a completely different platform, they are able to go there, right? And YouTube allows this story to be told and to be watched everywhere in the world, right? But I feel like for the Latino community, for everyone in Latin America, like, to watch this, to know that there are projects like this, you know, being made here as well, and then we are able to consume them and to, you know, witness their love, is, it's honestly, it's encouraging, you know. It is very much like the first time I watched The L Word, you know, all those years ago, or South of Nowhere, or, you know, those series that I watch where I finally, you know, saw myself on the shows, you know. And this one is doing exactly that in a different platform. But for that, I think they have the freedom of not being censored. You know what I mean? But yeah, you know, it's amazing. And I will always bet, and I will always support shows and series or movies or whatever that are made in Latin America. Oh yeah, there was another, but it was on Netflix. It wasn't on like a, it was, I don't know the name in English, but I have watched that series for myself. Dos Madres, Two Moms, Two Mothers. I don't know. It's about the two moms that their daughters get switched and they end up falling in love, you know, and it's beautiful because you don't expect it. And then it's weird. It's a Mexican production, but it's for Netflix. So we do have that. But like, the more we get in the more places, the better, you know. And I just, you know, what this channel has done is just incredible, you know. And it's just so amazing that I get to witness this important part of our, it's history be made, honestly, because we are not, as Latinos, and you know, do we consume American television? Yes, we do. And like, you know, you will think, oh well, but we have The L Word, we have like several other shows that go there, and like they're more progressive and everything, and that's amazing. But that is happening in the United States, you know. Outside, we're talking about Latin America, you get examples like this, and it's just amazing, you know. And I love that. I love that. And I love how immediate we can connect all over the world watching this series. Honestly, it's a gift, you know. And it started as a fanfic, you know. And it's just mind-blowing that from that, you know, they bought the rights for it, or there was a book before or something like that. I don't know the story really, but, and then it got made for YouTube and all that. It's just, it's fantastic, and I truly love it. And yeah, anyway, so the story of the episode, finally, you know, redemption. Did what's Katarina redeem herself? I'm gonna go with like, kinda. I'm not gonna go full on like, yes, she did. No, but she did made progress, you know. She did said what she did was wrong, but at the beginning she was trying to excuse herself, or, you know, trying to let the husband know that, well, I was raised this way, my mom was like that. And like, I love the fact that the dad, you know, the husband was like, Marcus is his name, right? He was like, yes, we were from a different generation, and our parents were more disciplined and more harsh, and like, you know, but like, we don't have to continue doing that, you know. And then we are told from her perspective what it was like and what her relationship with her mother was like, you know, her mom never encouraging her on anything, on following her dreams, on whatever. Because I'm going to guess that at the time, all that the mom wanted was for her to get married, have her kids and not do any type of work or just dedicate herself to her home or something like that. And maybe she wanted to do some things differently, whatever. Was she able to do it or not? I don't know. But there was a lot of resentment that she harvested against her mom, I guess. And because of it, that's how she acted with Valentina, right? But it's so, that is something that is so sexist at the same time, right? Because she's not like that, not 100% like that with her son. She does make the wife, you know, Duda, you know, a little bit like she's overly judgmental, you know, but she's not the same way she is with Valentina like she is with Igor, you know. So the thing is, for me, yes, daughter, mother-daughter's relationships are very complicated sometimes, you know, and but I do like the fact that she recognized her mistakes and that, most importantly, she was able to forgive her own mom for, you know, and I don't think her mom was asking for that forgiveness, but she needed to give that forgiveness in order to move on. And I think they did it right. Now, it seems a little bit rushed, yes, but you have to understand that this show is only a 25, 30 minute show, and also it has short episodes, like per season. It's just 8 episodes. So you can spend like an entire season with her being evil, and by the end, because then you are not going to have any more arcs with her. So was it a little bit rushed? Yes. But at the same time, I feel like it paid off a bit. You know, at least they didn't put Valentina and her mom in the same room hugging each other and like forgiving each other on this same episode that she, you know, realized where everything came from. You know, it's something that she had to deal with, and she did. And she knows the steps that she has to take in order to be part of her daughter's life, you know? You know, I say, okay, I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't forgive her. But let's be real. At the end of the day, I did kind of forgave my mom. But it was after I had my son, when I understood the sacrifices that she had to make. Granted, I never asked to be born, so the things like food, you know, roof over your head, things like that, those are her responsibility, and my dad, but my dad was never there, and a lot of it fell into my mom and my grandpa, you know, and my grandma, my maternal, you know, side of the family. And but I understood a lot. I didn't understood her as a mom, but rather as a woman, you know, making those choices at the time by being a single mom and everything that entitled being a single mom, you know. So yeah, for me now it's a little bit more like my brother and I are a little bit more like, yeah, I mean, you were very strict. And we laugh about it, and you know, but it's not something that we should, but I guess that's the way we dealt with, you know, some of the mistakes that my mom could have made. But you know, the thing is that my mom was always there, you know, and I was able to understand her and let go of some of the anger that I had towards her, because my mom was very overprotective of my brother and kind of didn't care too much about me, or that's how I felt. But it was a different thing, you know. I understood my mom, you know, once I had my child a bit, and then I, you know, it was like, it's fine, you know. It's like I don't have that same, like, not guilt, but like anger towards her anymore, like I did even before I had my son, you know. So, and plus she's a great grandma, you know, so. Anyways, but it is very difficult to cut those toxic traits, you know, because my mom was very quick to, like, the only way for her to, that she thought that will keep us in a straight line and for us to be good, because we live in a very difficult neighborhood, was for her to be tough and to be severe and to use physical punishments, you know, and that was her way of like controlling things, which were unnecessary, but that's the way she did. That's the way her mom did as well. But with me, we broke the cycle, you know, and I'm glad because it's not continuing. Neither my brother or I are in any way, shape or form abusive towards our kids in any way, you know, because it's kind of like, and we kind of make fun of my mom because we are like, sometimes our kids are doing something and we're like trying to discipline them, but like with very stern voices and like correct them and like being like, you know, and my mom is like, oh, look, just let them be. If they broke something, it's fine. And we're like, dude, you didn't even let us breathe sometimes. Like, shut up. We're not doing anything bad. We're just correcting them. We're, you know, because we don't need them to be breaking shit up or, you know, you were even worse than this, you know. But my mom has a really, you know, those memories, you guys are exaggerating. I was never like that. Moms, they have very, they don't have, that's a part of their brains that apparently doesn't work. They don't remember that, those parts. But, you know, my brother and I are the complete opposite, you know, and we are like, my mom was never able to tell us, like, I don't remember, I can't remember, like, the amount of times where my mom said, I love you, to me. And I don't know about my brother, but I remember them, clearly, and they are, like, few. For me and my brother, we are all the time telling our kids how much we love them. All the fucking time, you know, even when we are, you know, they did something that they were not supposed to because we told them it was dangerous or something. But we end, you know, okay, you're going to be grounded, like no TV or no computer or something like that. But I still love you, you know, and like that, because that's not something in my mind. That's not something a kid should win. You know, it's not, my love is not for my son to win me over. Like, it's a default setting. You come out and the love is there. You know, I never, you know, and my mom used to do that, where her love was kind of conditioned to whether if we behaved good or we didn't, or if we went, if things went good at school or not, and things like that, you know. So for me, it's like, nah, it's a given. You might misbehave and I might be upset at you at points, but my love is still there. I still love you, even though you broke it, because Josh broke a TV once. It took everything within me to be like, okay, I need to calm down. You know, I need to, he didn't have a TV for quite a long time because he broke it and like, he didn't have money to replace it. But, you know, I was like, you're grounded you can't watch TV now because the TV is broken. So that's part of your punishment as well, you know. But, you know, even then I was like, at the end of the day, I love you. Like, even when he calls me bro now, I'm like, really? Fine. But I still love you, you know. So, yeah, but it's just, it's like that, you know. But I'm glad that Katarina kind of saw the light. Let's see how it goes, because Valentina is not ready yet to forgive her. But she might be, eventually, right? And whenever she is ready, you know, I hope that the mom doesn't push her, because you have to forgive me. Like, it has been a week, so I already made my mind, and like, you should be forgiving me. I hope that she doesn't do that. I really do want to see a change in her. So hopefully we get to see it. Anyways, That's it. I'm going to stop ranting so I can watch the next episode. And I hope you guys enjoy it. I hope you guys like it. And I hope you guys continue to support it for more. So give a thumbs up, subscribe, comment, hit the notification bell on Cut Reaction. It's always posted first on Patreon in case you guys want to check it out. Link, as always, will be in the description down below. So thank you for watching. Thank you for all your support. You guys are amazing. And that's it. Yeah. See you guys next time for more reaction videos for, well, for episode 4, which is the last episode we have. For Stupid Wife. Yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching. Bye, guys.